Martin, yes, yes. Now the I've got it, another name here. It's fine. You have the floor.
Yes. Honorable Speaker, I hereby give notice that on Thursday, I shall ask the Minister of Work and Transport.
Can you wait for the mic? Yeah, yeah. I don't know why it's taking so long. Yeah, yeah. You know, we are experiment. Oh, yeah, here you are. You are on.
Oh, thank you. Honorable Speaker, I hereby giving notice that on Thursday, the 17th September 2020, I shall ask the Minister of Work and Transport, Honorable John Mutorwa, the following. Are there speed cameras on our national roads operational? If so, who is operating them? Number two, do they serve the purpose of which they were installed for, or is it just money wasted? Number three, can you confirm, Minister, that the software of these cameras is outdated? If so, was there a proper research done before it was installed? Number five, what is the future plan of the non-operational speed cameras installed on our national roads? I so submit. The second question, I here give notice that on Thursday, the 17th September 2020, I shall ask the Minister of Agriculture, Water and Land Reform, Honorable Kale Shortwain, the following question. COVID-19 has taught us to be self-dependent, especially on food production. The northern regions are blessed with water and fertile land. For instance, Wangwena region has underground water. The Minister of Agriculture, Water and Land Reform was quoted in the media as having saying that agriculture is the way for the economy in this country. Thus, I ask, what are the intermediate plans to make sure that Namibia is self-sufficient and able to export product to other countries in order to create employment for the unemployed youth roaming in our street? Malta, a small country in Europe, was able to produce enough potatoes and was able to donate consignment of potatoes to Namibia. Why is it that a country such as Namibia is not able to produce enough food to feed its populace? Number two, most of our northern rural areas, such as the area I visited, Kakondorokwa, Amarika, Onanjanja, and many more, are still using waters from wells and boreholes, which is unsanitary and unsafe. What measure does the ministry have in place to ensure such communities have access to potable clean water? I so submit.
Thank you. Next, Honorable Malima, you have the floor.
Honorable Speaker, I hereby give notice that on Thursday, the 17th of September 2020, I shall ask the Minister of Industrialization, Trade and SME Development, Honorable Lucia Ajumbu, the following. Namibia Intellectual Business and Property Authority, BIPA, was established in terms of the Business and Intellectual Property Act, number 8 of 2016. It was established to promote, enhance, promote the efficiency and the effectiveness of registration of businesses and industrial property in Namibia, amongst many of its established functions. However, BIPA has not fulfilled the mandate. Business registration is terribly low. Queues are long. The authority has not diversified enough. Therefore, I ask the following to the minister. Number one, when will the minister intervene to make sure that the terrible slow pace of which BIPA registration business is shortened and acceptable in a practical framework? which the business is friendly. Namibia is losing out a dozen of businesses investors because of long framework that BIPA is taking to register businesses. Number two, when will BIPA diversify and establish branches among its major towns like Swakopmund, Oshakati, Rundu, Katima Mlilo, Ketmansop, and Hobabis, to mention a few, to speed up the process of application and registration of these businesses and industrial property? Number three, why did BIPA not renew the contracts of more than 40 of its former employees who were left to go in this August 2020, while the authority is low on staff? If anything, this is just to make the approval of application and registration even more slow. I so submit.
Thank you.